Well, next, as I said, they're going to give us an example of Stokowski, the wizard of the orchestra, conjuring up his own arrangement of the famous suite of piano pieces, which Mussorgsky called, collectively, Pictures at an Exhibition. We hear the orchestration by Ravel so often, it's easy to forget that there have been many alternatives. A pupil of Rimsky-Korsakov led the way back in the last decade of the 19th century, and successors include Henry Wood and Walter Gurr. So what characterises Stokowski's recipe? Well, for a start, an instinctive feeling for the Russianness of Mussorgsky's score. He felt that Ravel, for instance, had made the Slavic colours of the original far too French. In fact, Stokowski went as far as to omit two of the French pictures, so you won't hear either Tuileries or Limoges at all in his version. However, the overall impression is of something earthier, and Stokowski would claim more congenial to the Russian temperament. What's more, in some of the spookier pictures, such as the portrait of gnomes, Stokowski's imagination is definitely on the macabre side, as you'll hear. So let's just wander through the gallery and use our own imagination as to what's on view, accompanied by Mussorgsky's recurring promenade theme and with Leopold Stokowski as the gallery guide. Well, the audience at the Royal Festival Hall certainly seemed to appreciate that version of Mussorgsky's Pictures at an Exhibition, which they were hearing in the orchestration by Leopold Stokowski, played by the BBC Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Sir Andrew Davis. And I think it makes a refreshing change to hear that work in a different painting, so to speak. Particularly liked the way the promenades were orchestrated, very, very imaginatively.